टू एवरीवन, मेरा नाम डॉक्टर भारत शाह, एनआईएफटी रायबरेली। एनआईएफटी के बारे में तो आप लोग परिचित होंगे ही, नेशनल इंस्टीट्यूट ऑफ फैशन टेक्नोलॉजी। ये मिनिस्ट्री ऑफ टेक्सटाइल, गवर्नमेंट ऑफ इंडिया। पूरे देश में ये 16 सेंटर हैं और उत्तर प्रदेश में ये रायबरेली में स्थित है। तो उत्तर प्रदेश में जो हमारे कोर्सेज चलते हैं वो 5 कोर्सेज हैं, फैशन डिज़ाइन, एक्सेसरी डिज़ाइन, लेदर डिज़ाइन, फैशन कम्युनिकेशन और एक पीजी प्रोग्राम है, मास्टर ऑफ फैशन मैनेजमेंट। तो ये 5 कोर्सेज हमारे वहाँ चलाए जाते हैं स्टेट ऑफ यूपी में। मुझे यहाँ कीनोट एड्रेस के तौर पे इनवाइट किया गया है और मैं जिला प्रशासन का धन्यवाद प्रेषित करता हूँ। हम लोग शायद यहाँ एकत्रित हुए हैं अपने आर्टिजन्स के लिए, और वो आर्टिजन्स जो पीछे बैठे हुए हैं, मुझे लगता है उनके लिए एक जोरदार तालियां होनी चाहिए। बहुत गंभीरता से वो लोग सुन रहे हैं सभी वक्ताओं को, और इन आर्टिजन्स के लिए चंद लाइनें मैं समर्पित करना चाहूँगा, क्योंकि हम लोग सिर्फ उन्हीं के लिए यहाँ पे इकट्ठा हुए हैं। कौन कहता है कि आसमान में सुराख नहीं हो सकता, कौन कहता है कि आसमां में सुराख नहीं हो सकता, एक पत्थर तो तबीयत से उछारो यालू। थैंक यू। सो लेट मी इनिशिएट माई एड्रेस। इन्वाइटेड आर्टिजन्स, ट्रेडर्स, डिजाइनर्स, मार्केटियर्स, रिटेलर्स, गवर्नमेंट अथॉरिटीज, रिप्रेजेंटेटिव ऑफ रिप्यूटेड इंस्टीट्यूशन फ्रॉम डिफरेंट सेक्टर्स ऑफ इंडिया एंड इंटरनेशनल एक्सपर्ट्स, ऑल रिप्रेजेंटेटिव्स फ्रॉम प्रेस एंड मीडिया, लेडीज एंड जेंटलमैन। इंडिया इज अ लैंड ऑफ एक्सट्रीम डाइवर्सिटीज, बी इन कल्चर और एथनिसिटीज, रिलीजन, आर्ट और क्राफ्ट। वी आर ब्लेस्ड टू हैव सच अ रिच कल्चरल हेरिटेज। व्हेन इट कम्स टू क्रिएटिविटी ऑफ आवर पीपल, एवरी नुक एंड कॉर्नर ऑफ आवर कंट्री इज इमर्ज इन इट। वी नो हाउ टू रीच मून बाई एयरक्राफ्ट एंड ऑल्सो हाउ टू मेक द इंट्रिकेट जरी सारी और चिकनकारी विद हैंडीक्राफ्ट। व्हेनेवर वी टॉक अबाउट द हैंडीक्राफ्ट इन इंडिया, फ्रॉम पश्मीना शॉल ऑफ कश्मीर टू काजीवरम ऑफ साउथ इंडिया, एंड फ्रॉम ब्लू पॉटरी फ्रॉम जयपुर टू बैम्बू क्राफ्ट फ्रॉम नॉर्थ ईस्ट, एवरी स्टेट ऑफ अवर कंट्री हैज़ एन इन्यूमरेबल वेराइटी ऑफ हैंडीक्राफ्ट विद फुल ऑफ ए पैथोरा ऑफ क्रिएटिविटी ब्रिमिंग। India is a land of extreme diversities, be in culture or ethnicity, religion, art or crafts. We are blessed to have such a rich cultural heritage in the form of handicrafts. Continuing towards the vast range of handicrafts in India, there is a most special craft of Uttarakhand, Pehniya handicraft, which is a fine and delicate craft, and the utility it provides is sustainable in nature and also need of air. Every day course can be carried out by these beautiful and sustainable products. But now, with the advent of technology, we have immensely transformed ourselves and have found alternative ways of doing everything. On one hand, where technology has eased our life, on the other hand, it has shortened our lifespan also. The handicraft sector is also not left aloof by this. It has also been affected. Also, since machinery has taken over skilled handwork and craftsmanship, it is adversely affecting the employment in this sector. People are not willing to take these crafts down the generation due to low wages and little or no recognition. Hence, all these crafts are at the verge of extinction. All the expense of the environment, we humans are paying heavily with the use of plastic. 90% plastics are recyclable, and most of us are aware of this fact. In order to have a sustainable alternative, it is a high time that we should now take a step towards improving the scenario and limiting the use of plastics. This can be done in the products are marketed in a way that they are fit into the requirement of the people and also the environment as a whole. In this regard, we can work on a few suggestions from sustainability of handicraft and also for upliftment of artisans. The design community, design processes, and designers can also have social impact, hence recognizing the need of primary condition of design. Society strives to contribute to the broad and rigorous understanding of all aspects of design, and to promote the use of design knowledge for the good of humanity and the world we live in. Design plays a vital role in making the product unique from the other. Designers' involvement with the craft can make the craft reach new heights. To help the indulgence of design in craft, we can help develop design ranks for various crafts related to product categories in the textile, carpet, and leather industry. The design banks can be product and geography specific, with further elaboration on material, fabric, color, quality, etc., like different designs, material, fabric, color, and quality parameters for Americans, Europeans, and other international markets. These designs should be in ready-to-use format. Designs can be uploaded on machines and can be printed on the trace paper for future use. A web link and app can be created wherein all designs should be available for the craftsmen. Also, design search facility can be made available in the database. Develop a platform for artisans where they can do all formalities for registration, like type of paperwork, and like single window system. Handicraft can be leveraged the government flagship programs like Make in India, Skill India, and Digital India. Identify the various scope of PPP model in the Indian handicraft sector. Create a demand supply model for Indian handicraft, which will lead to sustainable business. Develop an action plan while identifying the development needs and suggestion new and innovative pathways through which Indian handicraft will compete with the global market. There are innumerable crafts clusters in India. Many are still unknown to the people, and also the artisans who are pursuing these are not in a position to sustain themselves or the craft. Due to lack of recognition and lack of proper help and support, sustaining them is now the biggest challenge, and we need to put in all our efforts to do it. This is the only way in which we can safeguard our rich heritage. National Institute of Fashion Technology, being an institution and platform where the skill and talent are always appreciated, we have made certain initiatives and efforts in order to uplift the craft of our country. NIFT regularly conducts the craft bazaar for various artisans of UP state from time to time, in which the artisans participate from handloom and handicraft clusters like brocade from Varanasi, cotton and silk from Kotwar, Ramnagar, woodcraft from Varanasi, daris from Sitapur, lacquer toys from Varanasi, bone carving from Barabanki and Lucknow, Meenakari from Jaipur, Mooch grass from Allahabad, Terracotta from Lucknow, Chickenkari from Lucknow, Gulabi Meenakari from Varanasi, Shazar Stonecraft from Banda, Basketry work from Lucknow, Wood carving from Nagina, and Jewelry work from Nagina. Various visits of the students of National Institute of Fashion Technology are conducted every year to study various craft clusters in Uttar Pradesh and other states of India, which keeps them in sync with our rich heritage, since these are the young minds and will make a difference tomorrow when they move out from the college and work in a professional world. We also organize awareness workshop for artisans from various clusters in Uttar Pradesh and other states of India to create awareness towards the market trend, latest design and marketing techniques for enhancing their business. During the last 3 years, we have imparted training to approximately 250 khadi kamgars of Uttar Pradesh. The range of diversity in living traditions in handicraft and in textile, particularly handloom in India, is nothing short of breathtaking, and it has been an ongoing effort in NIFT to document and showcase the knowledge and to impart to its students and students a heightened understanding of legacy and technical skill of multidimensional Indian craft traditions. This effort has gained a flip through the craft cluster initiative supported by Development Commissioner Handloom and Handicraft, which has institutionalized the initiative in the curriculum of all design and management courses of NIFT, so as to build these synergies of sustained interaction with the craft communities in all corners of the country. For sustaining artisans for a better life and future, we need to put our efforts together to do the same. At last, I would like to extend my sincere thanks to Shri Mayur Dikshit, Chief Development Officer, Udham Singh Nagar, and his team for inviting me to the stage at such a prestigious event, Uttarakhand Handicraft Symposium. Thank you so much. मैं अपनी बात इन चंद लाइनों से अगेन खत्म करना चाहूंगा. मंजिलें उन्हीं को मिलती है जिनके सपनों में जान होती है. मंजिलें उन्हीं को मिलती है जिनके सपनों में जान होती है. पंख से कुछ नहीं होता, हौसलों से उड़ान होती है. ये लाइनें मेरी समर्पित है आर्टिजन्स के लिए. थैंक यू, धन्यवाद, जय हिंद.